The great credit, the abundance of silver and gold, greed blinding honor, the offense of the adulterer becomes known, which comes to greatly dishonor.
A week and a half before the 2016 election, Donald Trump's personal attorney paid a porn star named Stormy Daniels to keep quiet about her alleged relationship with the Republican candidate for president. Today, that arrangement is well on its way to becoming the most talked about hush agreement in history, with potential legal and political implications for the president. Through his spokesman, Mr. Trump has denied having an affair with Stormy Daniels.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Beloved ulama ikram, I guess you've heard of Nostradamus. I mean, he's not any stranger to, I'm sure he's not a stranger to any one of you. My position is that he was a soothsayer. He dabbled in dark arts, alchemy, and that sort of those sort of practices, which are strictly forbidden in Islam. And my position is that many individuals who claim themselves to be prophets, who actually have dabbled in these sort of dark arts, are actually just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through wahi and ilham. And specifically where he has stopped with our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but through ilham, again inspired saintly individuals or through wahi, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the same way, Iblis la'natullah alayhi is a copycat, and he was inspiring certain individuals who had allied with him and were invoking his powers. His inspiration, his guidance, and were allied to his cause. Those are the individuals who were then inspired by Iblis Lanatullahi. And certain this book of quatrains, which is quatrains basically in and of itself means that they were little couplets of four lines, were prophecies done by Nostradamus in his time. We've seen a lot come to fruition, Hitler and Hitler, and you've heard those sort of things. But all of that you take with a pinch of salt, because you can see now the grubby fingerprints of Iblis Lanatullahi alayhi on all of this, that he was bringing these certain events again to fruition. And on his part, I understand, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, is that it's almost like a mockery of Lawhi Mahfuz and what's encapsulated in that. Because all of this has been predetermined, and he's trying to show some level of maybe control over the reality in Alami Wujud by prophesizing, forecasting these events, and then bringing about conditions through inspiration, through guidance, through direct guidance to the Shayateen in Ints, and bringing about these certain events in Alami Wujud, in our reality, subhanAllah, through them. This is one that I wanted to draw the attention of our beloved ulama ikram to, as it again points towards this particular year, 2018 specifically, and that he had prophesied that this would happen, and Nostradamus had, and we're seeing that unfolding as we speak on the mainstream. So again, straight away, subhanAllah, it drew my attention. And I could feel that there's something very, very eerie about it. There's a lot of talk about Stormy. The name is Stormy Daniels. And what we're seeing is his talk. And all of this lends into predictive programming. Because prior to that, you remember a while ago, or quite a few months ago, Donald Trump had talked about this is the calm before the storm. And the storm that I've been referring to, and this is again lends into predictive programming and conditioning of the mind and the psyche and psychology, is that they're trying to preempt and precondition the Ummah for the war that's literally on the horizon that we have spoken on of ad nauseum by now, and have explored quite some length. And subhanAllah, all of that is again outlined in the science PDF as well as archived on the channel. I just wanted to draw your attention to this because I think it's almost like a harbinger of what is going to happen following this. Certainly we've been off by a season We felt very strongly that they would start it in the winter months. We've entered the spring months. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, but it seems like we're probably off by a season in terms of when the shayateen and jinn are looking to bring about this war. And again, my position will remain that all of the key players on both sides of the conflict are part of the same dialectic and serving the same dark forces, and it's to bring about a synthesis which is a universal governance at the end of all of this, right? And a universal currency when the economy will certainly collapse as a result, and then a universal military as well, and the reins of which would be passed on to Dajjal Lanat Lele when he makes his grand appearance. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect and guide us. I just thought that I'd maybe perhaps draw your attention to this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Jazakallahu khairan wa asalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.